wearing number 4 from McNeese State, Joe. Some toughness.
That's Joe Dumars. He doesn't say much.
A three-pointer block. It's a great play by Dumars. Dumars does nothing but put the cap on a tremendous performance.
I am so excited to welcome Hall of Fame player and executive vice president, head of basketball operations for the NBA, Joe Dumars, to the show. Joe, thank you for stopping by.
Thanks for having me, Malika. Thanks.
Of course. So I want to start with everyone's favorite topic, some officiating trends. Okay. They are taking shape this season. There were 1.27 travels called per game last year, but that is up significantly to 2.93 this season. Why is traveling such a point of emphasis this year?
So two things I'll say, Malika, is one before the season started, we made it a point of emphasis this year that, look, we have to start calling the traveling. It's getting really crossing the line. The second reason, and probably most important reason, Malika, is because it gives such an advantage to the offensive player. Mm. It's hard enough to guard an NBA player just taking two steps. I mean, these guys are incredible. They're elite. We're the elite league in the world. And it's really hard to guard a guy. You give him a third and fourth step, it becomes impossible for the defender. So, you know, we just felt like it was really important this year to come out and make an emphasis on just the two steps, three, four steps. It's just too hard to guard.
I feel like in the moments, I'm thinking back to Steph Curry the other night when the game is on the line. That's when it sometimes gets like, really, we're calling that? So when players get frustrated in those instances, what's your message to adjust?
So here's my thing. I would say anytime the league puts in a new rule, Malika, anytime NBA players adjust, they're so good, no matter what happens, they're going to adjust. The thing I would say on this particular play here is this. The defense makes a great play. He defends Steph, right?
Yeah.
And he gets him to stop. Why should the defense be penalized? If you can stop Steph Curry on just one play, it's incredible. And so you don't want to penalize the defense. They make a great play. They get a guy kind of locked up, and you allow him a third and fourth step. It's just, it goes back to what I'm saying, just really unfair to the defensive player.
Okay, but how about penalizing? So we talked about this a little bit before the show, and I've said it on NBA Today before. I am kind of passionate about this. I think that there should be a little bit more leeway with some of the bench celebration or penalizing dunks like this one. Like, this is what makes the game so exciting. Tell me about this.
So I and you and I were talking off air. And I agree with you about we do not want to take fun out of the game. I want these guys to have a great time. And I know that sometimes it looks like we are being a little bit too strict. Look, we just don't want guys to cross the line. But as you and I were talking off air here, like guys having fun, mean mugging, doing whatever. Like, look, it's a part of the game. And so we should allow that to be in the game. We just don't want it to cross the lines. But I'm telling you, I come from an organization where, you know, we got close to the line a few times, I should say. So I'm not here now all of a sudden, like, you know, I don't understand that. I understand it and I love it. I love it for our league. I love it for our players.
Well, speaking of those teams that you were on, looking toward the finals rematch that we have between the Celtics and the Warriors Saturday on ABC, your Pistons team lost to the Lakers in 88, and then the next year you came back and you swept them. So how did you use that momentum of losing to turn it around the very next year and, oh, by the way, win finals MVP?
That's a great question, Malika, because once you get there, even if you lose the first time like we did, we lost the first time, but you leave knowing at that moment we're good enough to be world champions. And so you become so motivated. It does not surprise me that Boston has started off this year the way they have, because they've gotten there now. And they knew that in June last year, there were only two teams playing, them and Golden State. And so the confidence you get from that, to know that you're good enough to win it, it propels you into the next season. And that's what you're seeing with Boston right now.
Yeah, you can feel it around the Celtics right now. Joe Dumars, thank you so much for spending some time with us on NBA Today.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.